seems in a small town, everybody becomes a character. You know, like, if you think of a town of 75 people, you have Uncle Buck and Ben Bob. He has the name Ben Bob because he moved to town and bought a grain bin and turned it into a house. So Uncle Buck called him Ben Bob.
Ben Bob.
And his name's Uncle Bob, too. So everybody's an uncle.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, Henry Newdoor, because Henry owned the store and his store got broken into and they broke the door. He got a new door. Uncle Buck walked in and said, I got a new door, Henry Newdoor.
They've been grown ever since I've been living here. That's been my whole life. I've been watching them for years.
What do they mean to the town, you think?
The celebrities. Buys lots of steaks. Really good music.
Actually,
tell them a lot of notoriety.
The funny thing is, before he met his wife, we used to sing together in the Orange Crush Talent Contest in Brandon.
Yeah.
Yeah. So his wife wipes a country singer.
What's the saying? It's a rental, don't be gentle.
But this one's parental, so I don't know.
What am I doing? Putting my seatbelt on Westward. This
is the Chris Grew Up right here. Next to the floodwaters.
This is the South 40 Ranch. This is Uncle Buck's house. He's not home right now. He went to a horse sale. But yeah, he used to live just down the road, and it was the old Wheel Inn. See, that was his sign over there. Over there in the garage. Old Wheel Inn. And that's one of the first songs I ever wrote. But now it's called South 40 Ranch. That's his house. Doesn't look like much, but wow. A lot of history. One of the lines in Old Wheel Inn is, we ain't got much, but we sure are proud of what we've worked for.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You gotta love a country girl. Keeping it down home in this crazy world.
Us are all from Portage Prairie and area, Westburn, of course, which is 20 minutes north here. But we all grew up with a lot of, I know it sounds funny, but prairie influence. There's in Portage Prairie, there's a lot of great musicians, a lot of bands that all had a lot of great vocals and roots in sort of, you know, country music. And even though Dave and I were more rockers, we couldn't help but be influenced by these bands and people, you know, musicians in town.
The album is definitely a different approach. I think we got back to our roots when we were 12 years old. We used to just get together and jam, and that's what we did.
Come up with a guy, go, I got this great idea for a song, it's wicked, check this out, or this riff or whatever. And you'd play, and you'd sit there for hours playing it and try to turn it into a song. And basically that's how we approached this, was to sit down as friends, you get in a room, and just start hammering out ideas.
The Manitoba medley in the show is the Guess Who, Neil Young, and I think it all just sort of winds its way into what we've grown up listening to.
It might be a little more rockin' than people are you know, come to expect from us, but also harkens to, you know, sort of the early country roots that Chris really loved, like Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, and some of the 80s kind of country, I think, you know, maybe lyrically and also musically.